Hey guys, today I am showing you behind the scenes of a project that I worked on for February's Hearts prompt. That was part of my monthly art challenge for the 7-day challenges. And this prompt, when I was creating it, I was feeling very uninspired. I had no idea what to do with it. Honestly, I just started painting swirly things and whatever onto the paper with no real idea of what I was gonna make. I figured I could just do something sort of abstract, and partway through I was just kind of thinking I might trash it and do something else for the day for that prompt. But I kept going, and towards the end I kind of felt like it was looking very feminine, and I kind of liked that, and I figured that if I kept going, I wasn't really in love with what it looked like just as is, but I kind of felt like I could do something else with it. I could use it for a different project, and I felt that if I downloaded it and worked on it in Photoshop, I might be able to accomplish something that I enjoyed more. And so I did that. I took a photo and downloaded it into Photoshop and started erasing the background. That was the first thing that I did. It took a long time, guys. This is sped up like a lot. This takes a long time to do. But I was really happy with how it turned out. I did some editing. I moved a couple pieces around and deleted some things that I didn't really like the placement of. And then I ended up brightening up the colors as well to make them really a bright, pretty pink. And then I took some photos that I had taken in the past when I was traveling abroad. I took these photos of these pink flowers in Greece, and I thought they would be like the perfect color to go with this very abstract feminine watercolor design. And when I was in high school, I had done some projects that were kaleidoscopes, and you took parts and pieces of images and you created something that was very geometrical and very abstract and very pretty. And I decided I wanted to give that a try again. It's been a long time since I did it, and I don't fully remember how to do it. But so it took a few tries, but in the end I did get it to look very symmetrical and very nice. But yeah, I just took triangle pieces, and you can see it here. I kind of placed them together and duplicated and turned around, and what you see is not the full extent of everything. There is some parts that got cut off in the recording. However, this is basically the process that I had. And obviously this one that you guys are seeing right now is not the final design, because I had noticed after I finished it that it was not actually symmetrical at all. So I went back and remade it and tried again and had to still alter some things, but it turned out finally at the very end very nice. But after creating the kaleidoscope design, I just kind of copied and pasted and dragged around little small copies of the watercolor design, and I placed it into the kaleidoscope, which I thought looks really cool. And I'm actually very much in love with this design. I think it would make a really cool print just to hang on a wall, but also I feel like it could be really cool. I would have to edit it again, but I think it would be really cool to create this and make it into a pattern to print onto fabric that I could then make into something else, that like I could print it onto fabric and then sew something with that fabric, like a dress or something, that then would have that design on it. And I think that would be really cool. So if anybody knows how to do that, let me know in the comments, because I'm very seriously interested in doing that. But this is the final project. I think it turned out really cool. I'm really in love with it. I think it turned out really awesome. So if you guys liked it, let me know in the comments. I think I'm going to definitely do more of these designs because I had a lot of fun with it, even though it was very time consuming. But I'm definitely going to do more of these. And yeah, if you guys have any ideas or things that you'd like to see, let me know in the comments, and have a wonderful, beautiful day.